Hello Windows Universe, in this video we will talk about how to fix the InstallShield error 1152, error extracting files to temporary location. For a more in-depth look at the topic, we will link an article in the description down below. When performing these steps, make sure that first you create a system restore point in case there's any unwanted changes done to your computer, and that you have admin privileges. To clean up the temporary storage, you're going to have to go to Settings, System, Storage, then click on Configure Storage Since or Run It Now. It's possible to delete everything in the Windows TEMP folder directly, but if any of these files are locked, they will not be deleted. You can then use Disk Cleanup or Storage Since. So click on Clean Up Now to free up the space. This will also erase any TEMP files. Then I would also run the Disk Cleanup tool just to make sure that all of the temporary files were deleted. If you're extracting a zip file into another folder and receiving this error, it might be best to delete everything inside it. Sometimes if a previous installation wasn't complete, it could result in corruption. You can also try using a different location to extract the files and see if that works. And there might have also been a slight chance that temporary files location has a bad copy already from a previously done installation. It might be good to delete it and re-download the program and see if you can extract it then. There's also a possibility that you temporarily lost permission to a folder and then you cannot extract files into this. If for some reason you have lost permission to the folder in which you're extracting, this is what you can possibly do. Right-click on the folder and go to Properties. Go to the Security tab and check to see if you're listed under the user group. Select your username and see if you have the permission to read and execute. If not, click on the Edit button and give yourself those particular permissions. Once that's done, click Apply and click OK. If everything else fails, then the last way out of this is trying it in a clean boot. If there's anything apart from storage space or corrupt temporary files causing the problem, then there's a good chance this will fix it. To perform a clean boot and then extract or install the file. To do this, type in MSCON for system configuration. Click on Services. Click on Hide All Microsoft Surfaces, Disable All. Then go to Startup, go to the Task Manager, and disable any of the startup program. Then under Boot, click on Safe Boot, click Apply, click OK. Make sure that when you're done extracting the files that you go back and reverse all of this, otherwise it will reboot in a clean boot state next time that you restart. For more helpful articles to help you maximize your Windows experience, go to our website, thewindowsclub.com. Do not forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel, where we are always adding new content aimed at making you the master of your digital house. Thanks for watching and have a great day.